This is Emerge 11, an exhibit of 21 artists at Aljira, a center for contemporary art in downtown Newark, New Jersey.
This is an installation of a grow system. It's growing vegetables indoors. You are able to grow actually without sunlight if necessary and without soil. And it's an installation to encourage people to ask questions about agricultural practices and how food comes to your table and ask questions about pesticides and genetically modified foods and your food source and what that does to your health and what that does to our ecology.
So my name is William David Caballero, and I'm a multimedia filmmaker, composer, and video artist. And I was born in New York, raised in North Carolina, now I live here in Newark, New Jersey. My project that's here is definitely a project that I think has resonated with the viewers. It's a great homage to my grandfather as well, and his quirky, you know, opinionated, Spanglish character.
From North Carolina, when you ready to call me back, I accept that you call. I always do what I told you. Don't forget, you know what I mean. Bye, call me when you got time. Bye.
My grandpa saw the video. He was, because he doesn't really watch much except, you know, his gospel shows or, you know, baseball. So he watched it, and I'm like, because I really wanted him to love it, and he was like, people gonna think this is funny. I don't know. It's maybe a good. It's a good film, but okay. I don't know. It's just me. I'm no funny guy. So I think that he didn't really get it, but he definitely appreciated it. And right now we're actually working on a web series where the idea is that either on Facebook or Twitter, people can submit their questions for Grandpa or ask Grandpa for advice. And so it's almost like a talk show. Every week you can come back and see Grandpa sitting in this kitchen giving you advice on how to live your life.
But Emerge is more than this exhibit. It's also a professional development program for artists.
You know, they learn about practical matters from professionals in the field. Things like budgeting, things like marketing, preparing your work for presentation, those kinds of things that are not usually taught in art school.
We visited a few of the Emerge Fellows at their studios, starting with Fort Lee artist Tai Hwa Goh.
It's more biological images and then portrait of inside my body, what happens inside, and then stories based on the imagination about my physical rhythms and movements. And then, you know, how vulnerable we are, but, you know, how strong at the same time we are, our body especially.
My name is David Rios Ferreira. I live in Jersey City, work in New York, and I am an artist. Everything's appropriated. There's not really any image that I imagined myself. I might be reimagining existing images. So things like coloring books, a lot from Disney films, and I feel in a lot of ways, you know, with Disney films in particular, the narratives that they were playing with were appropriated as well. Those weren't the Disney, you know, that's why you have the Disney version. So essentially I'm creating the David version. I feel like a lot of the things I got from Emerge were strategies on how to apply what we typically see in business, what we typically see in trying to get a new job or trying to build our resume, and apply it to my art.
Back in Newark, we visited the studio of Nell Painter, a distinguished historian who, after retiring from Princeton University, began a career as a visual artist, starting with art school.
I live and work in Newark, New Jersey. My work is manual and digital in the sense that I physically paint, but I also compose and add colors on the computer. And I mix them together. I go back and forth. I make digital collages, often with historical themes, because I come out of a historical background. The Emerge program is a professional development. And many people think that if you're an artist, then it just comes to you and you work out of this blast of inspiration. But if you're a professional artist, you have to do it day by day. You have to keep at it. That's the big thing. And how you keep at it means, how do you balance making work that may not sell right away, and then having your family life and so forth, and then also having a community of artists around you who are on your side. That's really important.
There's more that goes on here than just putting pictures on the walls. I mean, that's what comes to mind when you think of a gallery. Aljira is in a sense a countermeasure to what's considered mainstream, and allows artists to explore ideas away from the vagaries of the marketplace. When I look around me, I see 21 very special artists. And I think that these are artists who go on to do fantastic things. I mean, they are Aljira's future. I'm hopeful that those are the people who are going to give back to Aljira.